I want to talk about God's faithfulness to you. Did you know that your only hope today is Jesus? It's true. You know, you got a lot of problems. You know that. I don't got to tell you that. But you got a lot of things that are coming against you. You struggle. You fall. You're not your best all the time. But let me just say this. You have someone living inside you that is greater than your hardships, who you may be at the moment. You have a covering. You have God on your side. And He promises to see you through. I was reading in Isaiah chapter 43. You know, the people of God weren't at their best. They weren't even doing the best. But God wanted to remind them of who His people are. Did you know that God wants to remind you of who you are this morning? He does. The enemy tells you one thing. People tell you what you've done wrong. People have a way of bringing you down. God wants to bring you up this morning. God wants to tell you how He sees you. And it's not by performance. It's not by doing everything right. You see, you can't do enough right to earn your way to Jesus. It's a gift. It's something that He's done for you. Maybe this is simple, but sometimes we need the simple, because that's the way it is. For God so loved the world. That's you, my brother, my sister. It's the love of God that carries you this morning. It's the love of God that covers you today. The scripture. Now, this is what the Lord says. This is what God says to you. You need a word this morning? You need God to speak to you? This is God speaking to you today. He says, He who created you, my brother, my sister, God created you. Now, is that a big deal? Yes, it is. God is the one that created you. You can rest assured this morning that you have a heavenly Father that is watching over you. He goes on to say, He who formed you. Now, what does that mean? Some of you think that you got to do it on your own. You got to strive. You have to perform a certain way. God's telling you this morning that He is forming you. Is that a big deal? Yes, it is. Because that takes a little weight off you this morning. It's not on your performance, it's God's performance. Here's what I want to say to you. God's going to get you there. It's hard. It's difficult. The enemy is attacking you. But God's going to get you there. You need to keep your head up. You need to keep praying. Why did we have a few extra songs this morning? Because as Sue said, praise precedes the victory that God is doing in your life. Sometimes you got to praise your way out of your depression. Sometimes you got to praise your way out of your faults. Sometimes you got to lift Him up even though you are low. And when you lift Jesus higher, all things have a way of working out. The devil don't like it. The devil don't like it when you lift Jesus higher. Then what happens? God has a way of doing what man can't do. He formed you, O Israel. Fear not, for I've redeemed you. I've summoned you by name. You are mine. My brother, my sister, don't fear what the world is trying to do to you. This world can be ugly at times. This world can be harmful. As a matter of fact, this world sometimes is not a pleasant place. But Jesus is telling you, fear not. My brother, my sister, you have nothing to fear today because God is with you. What does that mean? That means you could relax. You can take the weight off yourself. Listen, because all that the enemy has planned against you, it's not going to work out at the end of the day. The enemy tried to kill Jesus, and Jesus turned it around. The Heavenly Father turned it around, and it became the greatest redemptive story the world has ever known. Here's what's going on in your life now. The attack on your life is nothing more than a redemptive story in the works. It's going to turn around for your favor. You just need to hold on. You just need to stay with God. You just need to keep putting your trust in Him. Now listen, don't go the way of the world. Don't go and give your heart to the world. No. Back up and say, Jesus, I surrender to you. Why do we have communion? Why do we have corporate worship service like this? What it is, it's nothing more than a public confession. We come here and we get endued with power. We get more of God in us and less of the world. You need that. Because the devil is on you. The devil is trying to bring you down. God's trying to bring you up, my brother, my sister. Let me continue on. Here, I like verse 2. Because you know what verse 2 reminds me of? And listen, this is a word of God to his people when they weren't at their best. Are you not at your best right now? You qualify. Are you not 100%? Are you not at par? Well, let me tell you something. This word is for you. God wants to encourage you. God wants you to remember his word, what he says about you, not what the enemy is trying to say about you. So he says, when you pass through the waters, the question is not if you are, it's when you are. Listen, you are going to have trouble. I can't lie to you and say life's going to be perfect. It's not going to be perfect. Some people are going to hate on you. Some people are going to hurt you. As a matter of fact, you're going to hate yourself and you're not going to like yourself many times. But let me tell you something. God sees you differently than you see yourself. God sees you complete. God sees you not undone. God sees his son Jesus when he looks at your life. Now, what does that mean for you? That he is the one ultimately that is living his life through you. What you need to do is just surrender. And that's hard, that's difficult, but that's what you're doing right now, today. You're surrendering to God. You could have stayed home. You could have done something different, but you came to the house of the Lord. That's to be commended. You gave God your time, and now God is going to help you. God is going to work in your life, and God's going to fight your battles this week. Listen, you got a promise this week that God is going to fight your battles. He goes, here, when you pass through the waters, I will be with you. Do you need God with you this week? Yeah. When you pass through the water. Listen, we're not going to stay there. We're going to pass through the waters. My brother, my sister, you're not going to stay where you're at. You're passing through what you're going through. You're passing through that difficulty. Listen, the enemy does not have a grip on you. You're passing through it. And then he goes on to say, when you pass through the rivers, does it get harder? It does. Sometimes it even gets to where you feel like you're drowning. But let me tell you, Jesus is not going to let you drown. Jesus is not going to let you be harmed beyond repair. Listen, Jesus is with you right now. I know you're don't sometimes feel like it's going to work out. Sometimes you wonder. Sometimes you're mad at yourself for making the mistakes. But let me tell you, your worst mistake is not something that God cannot help you with. God wants to help you today. And he says here, when you walk through the fire, when you walk through the fire, what I'm saying to you is you're walking through it right now. Is it hard? Yes, it is. But you're not stopping. Are you going to stop where you're at? Huh? Are you going to stop? No, you're not. You're going to keep walking with Jesus. You're going to keep walking out your faith. You're going to keep praying. You're going to keep pressing in. You're going to keep calling on the Lord. And when you make a mistake, you're going to get back up, brush yourself off, and you say, Jesus, I'm yours. Listen. The enemy is trying to bring you down, and the enemy has lost. The enemy is trying to hurt you, but the enemy has lost. As a matter of fact, the enemy has tried to kill you. He has. But Satan is powerless when it comes against the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus is over your life, is protecting you. You've got a God in heaven that is fighting for you right now. Listen, the flames will not set you ablaze. Remember, the three that were in the fire, remember when they were in the, it says that they came out. They came out and they didn't smell like flames. As a matter of fact, the next morning, they came back and they say, are you still there, Daniel? Are you still there? Yes, there was another in the fire. My brother, my sister, there's another in the fire with you right now. His name is Jesus, and he's with you right now. God is with you in the fire. And what can you, wow, is that a big thing? Yes, it is. Listen, because God's on your side. I admit, man ain't going to stand with you at all times. Your family's not going to stand with you at all times. They're human too. They're no better than you. You're no better than them. What I'm saying is, man, their heart doesn't do it. It's not the best at all times. But you have someone that is at his best at all times. And he's over you. He's covering you. So here's what I'm saying. Rest in Jesus today. Rest in him, your heavenly Father, who loves you, who is with you, who's fighting your battles behind the scenes. Is he? Yes, he is. God's fighting your battles for you right now. You got a health issue. You got a relationship, something that you're needing God to help you with. Can you ask him to help you? Can in your closet time, you say, Jesus, I need you to go before me. I need you to help me. I need you to work this thing out. Jesus says you have not because you don't ask. Listen, just ask him. He'll help you. It's not complicated. Can you just give your heart to him? Humble yourself. Maybe God's waiting for you to humble yourself. Maybe God's wanting you to come to him as a child. Not proud and not arrogant, as a child. And ask your heavenly Father for help. Ask him to take the burden away. Ask him to fight your battles. Ask him to do what man cannot do. Let me tell you something. You'll find out he'll never disappoint you. God's not going to disappoint you. As a matter of fact, you're one turn away from a breakthrough that you're desperately needing. You're just one step away from God doing what you need to have done. Am I trying to encourage you? No, I'm trying to give you the word this morning, what God says about you. And the word will encourage you. Man will disappoint you. The word of God will encourage you because that's your life. So here we go. The last verse. For I am the Lord. There you go. For I am the Lord, your God. your God. Whoa, your God. You got a God in heaven. You got a God that's fighting for you. You got a God that flung the stars in the sky. You got a God that could put down every demon. You got a God that's strong. You got a God that believes in you. You got a God that is with you. My brother, my sister, I wouldn't sell yourself out to the world by no way. I would draw closer to him. In my last thought, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. Oh, I like that. Your Savior. Do you have a Savior? You got a Savior. Do you have a Savior? Come on, think about it. I know, once again, this is elementary, but I really don't care. Think of yourself as drowning and someone throws you a life raft. Do you need a life raft this morning? Jesus is throwing you a life raft. Come on, reach out to him. Grab it. Put yourself around it and let Jesus pull you back to shore. Do you need a life raft? I need a life raft. I need God to help me. I need God to save me. He's the Savior of the world. It doesn't matter what color you are, how much money you have, your Savior is Jesus Christ. He's the living, the God who lives for you. My brother, my sister, put the devil under our feet and say yes to God. Your Savior, the Holy One of Israel. He's holy. He's made holy through the sprinkling of the blood. Let's bow our heads. We love you, Lord. We love you. We love you, Lord. We love you. We love you, Lord. We love you. Help us, we pray. Help us, we pray. God, would you this week give my brother, my sister, an answer? Would you help them? This week, Lord, I believe that the ship would start to get turned around. God, I pray that you take the wheel. We're tired of driving it ourselves. We're asking you to take over our life. We're humbling ourselves before you right now, and we're asking you to take the controls of our life. We've tried it on our own. It hasn't worked. And now we're coming back to you. We're coming back to you. And we're saying, yes, Lord. Please feel free to ask Jesus into your heart this morning. Ask him to help you. Feel free to repeat this after me. Dear Jesus, I love you. I'm sorry for my mistakes. Come into my life. I make you my Lord and Savior. In Jesus' name, amen. We love you, Lord. We love you. We love you. We thank you. Lord, bless your people right now. Do the work. In the midnight hour tonight, in the midnight hour tonight, in the midnight hour this week, the angelic host visits you this week. In the midnight hour, angels visit you this week. In the midnight hour, you shall receive your breakthrough. In the midnight hour, God shall touch your tongue and you shall be redeemed and God shall help you and God will fight your battles for you. Let's stand together.